first set. Lendl to serve.
The champion to serve.
Ready. Play. Love. 30 love.
Here's one of Ivan's thunderbolts. Interesting to see if he goes for a lot of big serves. He didn't against Yannick Noah. Oh! First angle, bit of a murmur in the crowd as if they had thought the ball had hit in, and it did look very close.
Ball.
Ball. 40, 15.
In the semi-final, when Stefan played Mats, he wasn't anxious to get to the net, although he is a net rusher, and he's adopting the same tactic in the final. Quite interesting.
Advantage Lendl.
So the champion accepts Edberg's challenge and holds his service in the opening game.
Gamble and Lendl, first game.
It is from the reverse angle, the first serve straight to Lendl. His favourite forehand, the one up the line, or if he's in the backhand corner, he hits the forehand off towards the backhand. Here's the Edberg serve, hitting the mark 4 out of 4 times so far. Great percentage serve.
Lendl leads 2 games to 0.
Well, just a tremendous start by the world's number one. Return serve very, very soundly.
White, please.
The last backhand is one that he's worked on with Tony Roach. He's always come over the ball very well.
First service. 15-30.
From the reverse angle, and it did look just wide. Ivan did give the Lions lady a good hard look.
Out. 34. Quiet, please. Thank you.
So the champion loses his advantage in the third game of the opening set, and we're back to square one.
And that leads to game
two. Yes, well, that was an important game for Edberg because I thought he was the more tense of the two players. He mishit a few ground strokes in that opening game, so he may have settled down now.
Love. Fail to 15.
Scorching return that absolutely trapped Edberg at his feet. Incredible power generating from well above waist level, straight down at the feet of Edberg as he moved to the net.
Edberg
is on even terms, but not looking very safe. Backhand of Lendl's at 30 all, only just missed the sideline, and the forehand didn't miss by much, and it was going to be by him had it just gone over the net. So Ivan Lendl in great form.
Love 15. Love 30. First service.
This is Ivan's first ace. He's continuing to really go for his first serve because so far Edberg hasn't threatened to chip and charge. So there's no real penalty for Ivan when he misses his first ball.
This is when a lead cord is decidedly unlucky. Look at that, just sit up. And did Ivan whack that forehand? He hit it with malice. Really out there to show who is boss.
magnificent tennis by the champion, and he holds his serve at 3-2.
In love.
It is from the reverse angle, and this was a second serve, only centimetres inside the service line. The return well directed, just over the baseline.
Fail to love. Fail to 15. Game Edberg. Three games all. Fifteen love. Fertile love.
Rather unusual tactic here by Stefan. Fakes the approach but hits a drop shot. Ivan is right on the ball. Stefan's done that several times. It's not a bad play for a net rusher because when you go to make an approach shot, the opposition would naturally move back behind the baseline. Sometimes you can catch them off balance.
Fifteen. Game Lendl, ball change.
And again, great power from the number one seed as he leads 4-3 in the first.
Love.
Here it is. Great backhand volley, and that's made easier by the fact that Stefan gets so close to the net for the first ball.
30 love.
There's no one in tennis playing the first volley as close to the net as Stefan Edberg. It's a big advantage because it saves the ball from probably traveling an extra 3 or 4 meters.
Fail to 15. Fail to all.
This really is a smart play by Ivan Lendl. Short and wide for the first one. Set the chance up to pass down the line. Then he went for it when the position was vacant. Ivan really thinking well out there. A very complete player these days.
Game at Burn. Four games all.
No earphones today for Bob Hawke. He is
quite
right
pleased.
Into
thank
the
you.
Tennis. As is
thank
everybody
you.
In the stadium.
Quite
the
pleased.
Match is gripping.
Thank you. Love 15.
From the reverse angle, and that's Stefan's strongest side off the backhand. Has great versatility.
Love 13.
A great retrieving shot of Edberg's across court there. He went for it up the line, moved in, and then won it with the volley. You're not going to win too many points from the baseline with clean winners against Ivan Lendl. It's going to take a combination of shots.
Love love 40.
And Ivan under pressure for the first time this match responds with a double fault. Give Edberg three break points.
Just quiet, please. Fault. Thank you.
Stefan really hesitated before moving into the net. You could see him getting caught at the service line. So often is the case when Ivan has the choice, he hits the off forehand from the backhand corner.
Love 15.
Stefan Edberg has been maintaining a very high percentage of first serves. At 80%, Ivan down at 36%. Reverse angle, and you can see that Ivan is not going to give this first set up without a fight. Beautiful return of serve and even a better backhand pass straight up the line. Not gunning for the winner so much on the return of serve, just playing for position and placement. Edberg serving, just incredible, rarely missing a first serve. There is identical percentages of wins when the first serve goes in, but getting more than double the percentage of first serves in. Set point for the Swede.
Quiet, please. Thank you.
And history is now against the champion. Only twice in the last 25 years has a player come from losing the first set to win the Australian Open. Mark Edmondson in 1976 and Mats Wilander in 1984. So So John Edberg's off to a great start.
15 love.
Yes, and I think this really guarantees us of a tremendous final because Ivan will not be beaten easily. He's here to play. He played an excellent first set, just a little slip up, and Stefan was there. Seems totally unfazed by the loss of the first set. He's hitting every bit as strong as he was during the first set. No hesitation, no flutters. And here Stefan decided to chip and charge. Really didn't get much of the ball. It went very, very short. Caught Ivan off balance. Short sliced approach was a shot that worked so well for Yannick Noah during this tournament until he came up against Ivan Lendl.
Champion holds his service in the opening game of the second set, but trails by one set to love.
First double fault for Stefan Edberg, and Ivan must have overheard some of Alan Stone's comments from the side of the court, saying that he hadn't taken his opportunity to go to the net because in the first game of the second set he did intentionally move to the net after good shots.
Love 30. Love 40.
That's just a lapse of concentration after the relief of winning the first set. Something Stefan should have guarded against.
Out. 15-40.
A little checking with Bruno about an overrule. Excellent lob. If it misses, only just out.
Fine, please. Thank you. Yes. Gamlander. Lander leads by two games.
Lendl fighting back like the champion he is.
Carbon copy of the first set. Lendl held the opening game and then broke Edberg to lead 2-love. But he gave up that advantage in the third game. Let's see if he can hold here.
In love. 30 love. Forty, thirty. Game Lendl.
Stefan Edberg indicating the ball was well wide, which it certainly appeared.
Lendl leads by 3-2. Sits beyond the court, thank you.
In a Grand Slam final, Ivan gives nothing. Mats would have had to have earned that set. Oh. Typical at the last point of the last game. If it's called in, he's around the net post.
In love. Fair to love.
This is tennis at its best. Both men hitting the ball with extraordinary power and accuracy, and the movement around the court of Edberg incredible. Edberg's second double fault. He's really giving his second serve a ride. Not
just nursing it in because he's planning on serving and volleying nearly every ball.
Quiet, please. Thank you.
Really losing the rhythm on his first serve.
Game Edberg. Lendl leads by 3-2. Quiet, please.
Rhythm, a key ingredient for Edberg's serve, as it is for most people, but more so because it's not the technically most correct action.
Love 15. Love 30. Love 40.
And quite a change coming over this match from extraordinary heights. Edberg lost his concentration in the previous game, double faulted consecutive points. And this seems to have thrown Ivan's rhythm off strangely. Down love 40. It's a physiotherapist for the ATP. I wonder if he's being summoned to the court.
Put 15-40.
John, you're wondering about the loss of rhythm on Edberg's serve. It seems to me that he's just feeling his stomach muscles around the left side every now and then, and I think he may have got a bit of a problem there, and that would account why all of a sudden he's lost rhythm on the serve, but we'll just follow it closely.
There's the break back, but Lendl still leads 3-2. That is the scene that's confronting Stefan Edberg. He's received work on his stomach area, as Alan Stone indicated, the left side of his stomach. A change of ends, that was ice that was being rubbed there. But not a good sign. It was only 12 months ago when he had to retire from the tournament. his quarterfinal against Thomas Muster, couldn't take the court after injuring himself.
Any sense.
The round of 16 clash with Pat Cash.
Love 15.
In arching his back, he does stretch his stomach muscles a great deal when he serves.
Love 13. Quiet, please. Thank you.
And Edberg forces his way in while he's safely into the open court. Well, this must be just absolutely heartbreaking for Ivan Lendl. He played the most perfect return of serve, the forehand on the run. It's a magnificent shot.
Thank you.
Edberg covering both and handling everything that Lendl could throw at him.
From love 40 back to juice.
Must wonder what's happening. It's almost brought to the net by a short ball by Edberg, so he could pass him. Ivan could be a little confused. Edberg receiving physiotherapy on the change of ends and then down love 40.
Deuce.
Thank you.
Advantage Lendl. Deuce.
Another tremendous return of serve on break point for Lendl, but not being able to crack Edberg.
Advantage Edberg.
Incredibly, it was Lendl who got impatient, tried to force his way to the net and made an error in trying to do so.
Second set.
And as Ivan so often does when new balls come in, he takes a racket, a fresh racket, freshly restrung, and they're gripped.
Magnificent crowd in here today, and in the blue shirt, Steve Vizard, who tomorrow night will commence his Tonight Live program on network at 10:30. It's sure to be a winner, and Steve, an enthusiastic spectator amongst 15,000 other people
Seats
at
quickly,
the National Tennis Center. Lendl with new balls. Seats must feel like he's lost a couple of opportunities. Led 3-love in this set, then had Edberg at love 40. And he's back to 3-all, remembering he's trailing by 1 set to love. It's an important time for the defending champion.
15-love.
Edberg accepts the correction.
So 10:30,
15-0.
Right around Australia tomorrow night for Tonight Live. Steve Vizard. Lendl in a really tight position here. 3-all, 15-all, but a set down. Led 3-love in the set.
30-15.
The fan must really be frustrated to find himself being more than matched by Stefan Edberg at the base of the line. That's Ivan's forte. Three all. The world's number one down a set. And Stefan has forced Ivan to change his tactics and try to come to the net, something with which he's not entirely comfortable.
Deuce.
And Ivan on the break point, just sliding in a half-pace first serve.
Please. Thank you. Advantage Lendl.
Yep. Well, Ivan Lendl really going through the whole gamut of emotions in this set, from annoyance, frustration to have the lead and then break points, and now relief that he in fact held serve there after being down.
Sit quickly, please.
But
thank you.
Edberg, I believe it's a recurrence of an old stomach injury from the spring of 88.
Sit, please.
88.
Thank you.
And
it
looks to me that it only affects him on serve and obviously also a smash. So I think Ivan Lendl is well advised
thank
when
you.
Edberg attacks the net, he should test it a little bit further by throwing up a few lobs.
Thank you.
Alan Stoner courtside. Edberg to serve, 3-4, second set.
Make it.
15, love.
And at this stage of the set, Ivan doesn't want to give Stefan any free points.
Help. 30, love.
First love game of the match in the 18th game.
Four games all.
This is the point where Edberg broke Lendl in the first set.
My please. Thank you.
So again, a critical time for the world's number one and defending champion.
Fifth in love.
First serves into play, Lendl coming up and Edberg going down a little. Still very, very good at 71%. And Edberg incredibly just pulling up short there. Oh, really wasn't out of reach. I think we'll see in this replay he could have got there, but just stops. Things not looking good for Stefan at the moment. This is getting a little bit like the 1977 final when Vitas Gerulaitis was playing John Lloyd. Vitas got cramps. Stefan Edberg thinks the serve was long.
40-50.
Mirabeau confirming that the second serve hit the line.
Well, it looked like a double fault from where I'm sitting directly opposite, and I think Stefan Edberg a little unlucky there with that call.
Now it's really appearing unlucky for Stefan, because had that other double fault been called, as Alan suggests it was long, it would have been 30-40.
Lendl survives and leads 5-4 second set.
Love 15.
The first real indication we had of injury was the consecutive double faults in the fourth game of this set.
Out.
Ivan playing it for all it's worth. Trying the lob again. That's the danger when you're playing shots against an injury rather than against the player. Two set points to level the match.
15-40. Quiet, please. Thank you.
And Ivan did everything but win this point, set the point up beautifully. Edberg off balance, it's rifled down the line.
Quiet,
look at that, just wide. One set point saved by Stefan Edberg.
Deuce.
This really must be frustrating for Ivan. As we said from the reverse angle, does everything correctly here. There's a magnificent passing shot, but Edberg just jags out the racket, a bit of frame, and it's a dead winner.
Advantage Lendl.
Brave second serve under the conditions. He really went for it. Great depth.
Quiet, please. Thank you. White. Yeah. Gamedra. Five games all. Fine, please.
Well, the champion had three set points to break this man, Edberg, and level at one set all.
And on two of them made great plays, but was denied.
Sits, please, beyond the court. Thank you.
So the next 15 minutes could tell the tale of this Australian Open final.
And it's these charges to the net that upsets the Lendl rhythm. And then that little half-court ball.
Quiet, please.
Lendl prefers to make his passing shots from behind the baseline. So they're full drives. Not quite as versatile as possibly Edberg is.
Love 15-40.
What a moment now for the champion.
Quiet, please.
Is there a little doubt in Ivan's face?
Thank you.
30-40.
Very similar to the backhand that Stefan played at love 30.
Quiet, please. Thank you.
Advantage, Lendl.
Here it is in replay. Lendl tries a drop volley. Edberg's there easily. Lendl onto that one with a vengeance. Our Prime Minister has something in common with 15,000 others at the moment here. He's loving this match.
Advantage Edberg.
Third break point for Stefan Edberg.
Quiet, please.
So the champion broken for the fourth time in the match, and this break is very critical.
Love 15.
Thank you. something very interesting here. You can see Edberg actually moving back for the lob and being caught off guard by the passing shot. Ivan Lendl, not the greatest defensive lobber. He hit one very famous one in a semi-final against Pat Cash on match point down of the US Open. What a match. Lendl
15-40.
Two break back points to force the tiebreaker.
Quiet, please. Thank you.
Ivan had three break points. Stefan's previous service game.
Gambler. Six games all, second set tiebreak. Lendl to serve. White, please. White, please. Thank you. Players are ready. White, please. Edberg. Quiet, please. Edward.
Now Now it's Ivan looking for the chance to come in, playing inside the baseline, which is unusual for him.
Quiet, please. Thank you. Thank you.
Great tennis under real pressure from Ivan Lendl. Edberg's in on a good quality shot. A little verbal reinforcement after the hit.
Talking to ATP trainer Rob Hanna, who together with Todd Sider administered to Stefan Edberg, and the problem is he's got a slight stomach muscle strain, and it appears to be getting a little bit worse as the match progresses. They've been applying ice
Ladies
to
and gentlemen,
the change
please.
Events to try to
quiet
numb
please.
Down the area, but I think the longer this match goes, the problem's going to get worse for Stefan Edberg.
Slain at courtside, keeping us up to date with the problems that Edberg faces. And that's not mentioning Ivan Lendl, who's won four straight points in the tiebreak.
5-2, Lendl.
Well, two of those points coming on double faults.
Six-two,
Lendl. Surely now the champion can close the set off. Had three set points in the 10th game. Four with him now.
Six-three, Lendl.
Roach, very intent. He knows the score. Ivan is only one service break point up. If Edberg wins both points here, he's only got one chance to win it on serve.
Again, second serve, Lendl.
And the champion walks to his set pumped up. All square in the final.
Oh. 15 love.
From the reverse angle. Molly not as penetrating as it needs to be, and when Lendl has time, he is deadly. Sixth double fault, and Edberg's first serve percentage, seventh double fault rather, is down to 68% from 80% earlier in the match.
In the wars, and Lendl must really fancy his chances here at one love in the third set.
Well, with me, ATP trainer Todd Snyder. And Todd, what's the extent of Stefan's stomach problems?
Well, he strained the muscles of his stomach on the left-hand side, and it's an injury that he has injured in 1986 and was forced to retire from a match against Mats Wilander, and he also re-injured those same muscles in 1988. So it has been a problem for him over the years.
What do you think his chances are of completing this match?
It's really difficult to say.
Sits behind the court.
Is he risking further injury by continuing?
Absolutely. And with the swirling wind out there today, he has not the same timing 15. That he would have if there was a still day or if the roof was closed. With the ball floating around, it's really difficult to find his timing, and you'll see that on the overheads.
And particularly, we notice that he's lost rhythm on the serve, so it would be affecting him pretty badly in that department too.
Yeah, his serve is not nearly as effective as it has been in this tournament and what it normally is. And he's got nothing on the forehand either. He's just rolling it back there.
What would be your advice if he comes at the next change of ends and asks for an opinion? That's putting you on the spot a bit, I guess.
Yeah, it is. We hate to see the guys risk further injury.
First service.
And further injury on this particular stomach muscle could keep him out of the game for about 3 or 4 months. So he's a real professional, and he's in control of his body. He knows his body very well. He knows how he can push himself and where he has to limit his game.
Well, it would be absolutely tragic considering the fate that befell him at last year's Australian Open.
Yeah, it's certainly bad luck. Bad luck for the fans as well as for Stefan Edberg, who's playing very well at this time.
How many more times can he actually call on your assistance, or has he had the allotted number?
Well, we like 14, to limit it 15. To 3 treatments per injury, but in a case like this, if I can be of any assistance to him, prevent him from further injury, or if I'm able to help let the match go on, then they're going to let me continue treating him.
Okay, thanks very much, Todd Snyder.
So Lendl holds. Alan Stone has been speaking with Todd Snyder, ATP trainer, who has put us Lendl right in the picture concerning Stefan Edberg. So Lendl, two love up. Third set. New balls, Lendl changing his racket.
And Bruno Ribeau rather concerned at the amount of time that Ivan Lendl is taking. He hasn't actually said anything. But Ivan is prone to exceed the limit. Very slow player. Between points. Stefan playing a very medium-paced first serve, then and just staying back. Maybe he thinks he could maintain that type of tennis longer.
Advantage Lendl. Deuce. advantage Edberg.
Incredibly, that's Stefan's first ace of the match.
Deuce. Advantage Edberg.
Lendl pressing for a double break here. Third game, third set, love two.
Advantage Lendl. Advantage Edberg.
Tony Pickard must be very concerned
for
his charge. They had high expectations of today's final, but Stefan definitely showing signs of injury now.
Chances for a double break. Edberg survives, but still trails in the third set.
Lendl leads by 2-1.
Welcome back after almost 2.25 hours. One set all, Lendl 2-1 with a break in the third set.
Thank you.
Edberg restricted with injury. An injury that occurred in the second game of the match when Lendl was serving. But gradually getting worse.
15 love.
Edberg serving that second game of the first set, and Lendl broke him because Edberg won the toss and elected to receive. 30 love, Lendl.
Edberg rather defensive at this stage, staving off the inevitable, it seems.
Lendl leads by 3-1.
It's a difficult match for Ivan Lendl to play at this stage.
White, please. Thank you.
Edberg changing his game from game to game. Serve very slow now.
Love 15.
A great pity for Stefan Edberg, his serve being probably more than 50% of his game, and he's been totally stripped of that weapon.
15-0.
Just to show, though, even when he makes his movements to the net, it's how effective it is against Ivan Lendl. Something for other players to be aware of.
Fail 2-15.
It is from the reverse angle. Still awesome power from the back of the court from Ivan Lendl. Doing all he can.
Well, despite his obvious disadvantages, Edberg maintaining some pressure on Lendl in this third set.
Lendl leads by 3-2.
His injury has just slowly deteriorated. There's no real evidence of it until early in the second set, about the fourth game, when he served two double faults in a row, was our first real outside indication.
15 love. Chile.
First serves in Ivan Lendl, increasing as the game goes on. First set he was only at 35%, so he must be up around the 60% over the last set or two, and ever more successful when it goes in. Edberg winning the majority of points when he comes to the net. Lendl been trying to get to the net, especially at critical stages, more than what he normally would have tried. He was forced to come to the net because of the ever-present threat from Edberg.
40-15. Lendl. Lendl leads 4-2.
And the champion's lost just 3 points in his three service games in the third set, so Edberg not able to put any pressure on him. Still a breakdown, 2-4.
Injury to Edberg and the difficulties having in hitting balls that are overhead. Nine double faults for Edberg. It's more than he served in any match so far in this tournament.
And surely now the champion has closed up the third set.
Ladies and gentlemen, because of injury, Mr. Stefan Edberg must retire. Game, set, match, Lendl. 4-6, 7-6, 5-2.
What a tragedy for a match that promised so much to end like this. The first, really for the first two sets, the tennis was at an extraordinarily high level. Edberg trooped on, although injured from the second game. He fought hard with all he could, but really there was no point in continuing. He was unable to be able to match Ivan, the number one player in the world. You can see the disappointment. He must be very, very hurt, both physically and emotionally. He's put so much into this tournament. His chances looked excellent, both before this match today and during the first set and a half. Similar fate befell the likable Swede last year, injured himself against Pat Cash. It was a back injury that time. And I think both of these injuries, you could probably lay the blame at his service action, where he arches his back so much to impart that wicked kick. But it does place a strain on his lower back and conversely on his stomach muscles. He's leaving the center court at the moment with Todd Snyder, a man who has treated him previously for this injury in 1988. Tony Pickard powerless to do anything. There is the champion, Ivan Lendl, so tough.
So Lendl defends his championship, but not in the way he would have wanted. 4-6, 7-6, 5-2, and in the long history of the Australian Championship, for the first time, the title has been decided by an incomplete match. Edberg injured and forced to retire. Lendl, still the champion.
Gives me great pleasure to be here, but I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate Jeff and Tennis Australia for the very fine effort they've done in organising this tournament. It's been a great thing for us to be involved with this for the last 5 years, and we appreciate the efforts they put into it.
I didn't hear you during the match, guys, over there. First of all, I would like to thank Tony, Samantha, Andrea, and all my friends for the support. Has been tremendous help, and thanks again. I think Jeff has thanked all the people, from ball boys and ball girls to the umpires and alliance people, through the ground staff and everybody who you don't see, but without them the tournament would be very difficult to run. Thank you people for coming out here. It's great when the stadium is full, and also Tennis Australia and Ford Australia for putting this together. It's just great that we can play in such a great stadium and with so many people supporting it. It's not the greatest feeling to win in this way, but unfortunately things like this happen, and I hope Stefan recovers quickly. He carried on for quite a while and he showed great courage, and I hope we get a chance next year, 12 months from now, to repeat this and slug it out all the way till the end. Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And that concludes official presentation on center courts.